wow, what a glorious day here in St. Louis, Missouri. And, man, I am embracing it. Good stuff. And in case you can't tell, I do still sound a bit under the weather. I'm trying my best to over-pronunciate everything, but I think I still sound a bit, I sound kind of... Wow, you know, you freeze frame that image, I'm a dead man. All right, so Mike, the situation. That's right, situation. The douche from the show Jersey Shore. He's getting a lot of heat because apparently he stole a handicap parking spot, and I'm trying to figure out how the situation could have stolen a handicap parking spot. I mean, think about it. How do you steal a handicapped parking spot if you're already mentally retarded? I would think the spot would be all yours. I really think that it's possible that my Adam's apple is actually getting bigger. I mean, I've got nothing else to say about it. I mean, what in the sweet chocolate Christ does the Adam's apple even do? I mean, it doesn't protect you from anything. I mean, if they want to knock you down, all they do is, it'd have to be like, yeah, whatever. I don't know, man. This thing's really, really driving me nuts. So, I might as well just showcase it. God. All right, wait a minute. Wait. Let's pull back here. I was just exposing the Adam's apple a bit, and I think I noticed something. I don't know. Can you see what I mean? Do you see what I see? Do you see what I see? All right. Do you see the formation of a double chin? I mean, do you see that? Look at that. I mean, alright, it's not possible for me to be any grosser than I already am. I get it. Face for radio. I understand. I look like an anteater sometimes, but I mean, really, I got a thin build. I accept my thin build, but do I really need to have a double chin thing? I mean, what? Self-loathing. Self-loathing. Let me tell you how hot that is. Well, I guess it's appropriate that it's a rainy, dreary day, because it's been 15 years. 15 years today that Tupac was gunned down. Tupac's mom says that it feels like he just died yesterday, which, you know, is understandable. I mean, how can it really feel like 15 years has gone by since we lost Tupac when the guy releases a new album every other week? Terrell Owens is saying that he will play football again. Nobody cares. Kendra Wilkinson is opening up about all of her postpartum depression and her struggle to keep her life on track with all of her postpartum depression. I gotta tell you, you know, I really do feel for it. It's gotta be a bitch. It really does. It's gotta be so tough to have, you know, nannies and security agents and, let's see, oh, yes, right, your own reality show, millions of dollars and a mansion, right? That's just got to be a bitch. Oh, and then you add to it the gift of a brand new life that happens to be your child. Yeah, I'm sure I would be depressed as hell. Okay, I know that vampires are still all the rage. Oh, you kids love the vampire stuff. So here we go. How about I give you a quick little look at Johnny Depp as an 18th century vampire in the new gothic film he's doing with Tim Burton. Have you seen it? Check it out. Well, if that doesn't wet your undead whistle, I don't know what will. Oh, wait, I know. How about the brand new trailer? That's right, the brand new Twilight trailer. I'm sure a lot of you Twilight diehards have already checked this one out, if for some reason you've been living in a self-induced coma, or perhaps you're living under a rock somewhere in Bikini Bottom. I will now throw you the brand new trailer for the brand new Twilight film. Get excited. Here it comes.
Don't let me fall down.
Never.
I, Edward Cullen, take you, Bella Swan.
For better or for worse.
To love.
To cherish. long as we both shall live.
This is how I'll remember you. Pink cheeks, heartbeat. I think I'd be used to telling you goodbye by now.
It's impossible. Whoa.
The fetus isn't compatible with your body. It's too strong and fast growing.
It's crushing you from the inside out.
Your heart will give out before you can deliver.
You did this.
I can't see Bella's future anymore.
We don't know what they bred. We have to protect the tribe before it's too late.
You're the enemy now. Sam won't hesitate. You will be slaughtered.
I'm starving you by the hour.
I'm the one who'll lose you.
You have to accept what is.
You've given me no choice!
Get ready. They're coming for Bella.
They're not gonna touch her.
If you kill her, you kill me!
That was it? Alright, look, the movie probably is gonna suck balls, but I gotta tell you, I would still drive a stake right into Kristen Stewart. Look, you know, sometimes my thoughts for the day are nothing more than the random things that pop into my head that I decide to share. Sometimes they're extremely inspired by moments in pop culture, or by Lady Gaga reminding me that she is manipulating and destroying the integrity of people, as well as the sanctity of some situations. Other times, I completely rip off other things in order to get my thoughts across. So, without further ado, my final thought is not even mine, but instead, some words of wisdom that pretty much sum up everything I feel at this exact moment.
Yes, you're right more than everybody else. Yes, you make us a lot of money. But I think it's more appropriate...
Look. I need this. Just say, Melvin, I'll try, okay?
Melvin, I'll try.
Thank you. That's good.
Now, on a pleasanter note, my son, he just got accepted to Brown. My husband was dying.
Yeah, good, nice, thrilled, exciting. You don't have to wait with me.
I can't resist. You usually move through here so quickly, and I just have so many questions I want to ask you. You have no idea what your work means to me.
What does it mean to you?
That somebody out there knows what it's like to be in here.
Oh, God, this is like a nightmare.
Oh, come on, just a couple of questions. How hard is that? How do you write women so well?
I think of a man, and I take away reason and accountability.